often we talk about yuccas in the landscape, but today I wanted to give them a little bit more attention. Yuccas in general are a really great landscape plant, especially for Oklahoma. They are native and they can handle zones 5 to 11, so they can handle a lot of conditions. Now, the only real requirements they need are well-drained soil and also full sun. There's a couple of varieties that actually do even better in Oklahoma that I wanted to mention. This particular one is known as Adam's Needle Yucca or Yucca filamentosa. It actually got its species name because of the filaments that come off of those leaves that you see that look kind of like threads hanging from them. Now, it will grow larger and larger, and in fact, when it's flowering, it will produce a spike anywhere from 5 to 8 feet tall, but possibly even larger than that. As the plant grows, it might get some height to it as well, but it will also produce offsets off of the main plant, so you'll start to see clumps of these form as well. Now with Yucca filamentosa, there are a couple other cultivars on the market if you're looking for a little bit more interest in the vegetation. One is called Bright Edge that has a green leaf with yellow margins, and there's also Color Guard that has a yellow leaf with green margins. Now the neat thing about yuccas that is happening right now is that they're in bloom, and this is actually a really critical stage for a symbiotic relationship that you might not be aware of. So the only pollinator for yuccas is the yucca moth, which is a small white moth. So as it has hatched out of its cocoon that's in the ground, it actually flies up here looking for a mate, and so this is sort of a breeding ground for those yucca moths. Again, it's a small white moth, so you don't necessarily always see it in the flowers. It blends in really well. But what happens is the female will then lay her eggs in the flower. As that larva then hatches from those eggs, the larva will feed on some of those seeds. But that symbiotic relationship happens because the yucca moth, in that process of mating and laying those eggs, will also pollinate those yucca flowers. Now, even though the larva will eat some of the seeds, it knows not to eat too many of them, and so therefore the larva is able to get some food from this yucca as well to reproduce again for the next season. So it's an interesting symbiotic relationship that's happening. Now, there's another yucca that's native to our Oklahoma, and that's Yucca glauca, which we often see in western Oklahoma. It has a similar look to this Adam's needle or Yucca filamentosa. However, instead of the broader leaf, it's going to have a more narrow leaf and is even a little bit sharper on its tips. So you want to be careful with it also. It's a little less forgiving when you back into it. Now, regardless of which yucca you use, you want to make sure that when you plant them in the landscape, you're not planting them next to a sidewalk or next to a play area, because again, those tips can be a little bit pokey if you back into them. Now there's another landscape plant that we often reference as yucca, and that is a red yucca. It actually is not in the asparagaceae family as the true yuccas are. It is in the agaveaceae family. It's going to have a similar growth habit, however, it's going to stay at its lower clumping height of 2 to 3 feet. Now when it does bloom, it's going to have a spike of about 5 to 6 feet tall. It's really going to grab people's attention because of that red color. Now when we say red yucca, that's a little bit of a range. It's sort of a rosy soft pink to a red color. If you're looking for a true red, you want to go with a cultivar called Break Lights, as it's going to give you that bright red color to it. Again, there is another cultivar though, if you're looking to add a little more variety into your garden. While it's a fallacy that red yucca is even a true yucca, it's also not necessarily a red yucca. In fact, there is a cultivar that is a yellow red yucca, if you will. It is still a Hesperala parviflora. So it's the same genus and species, but a different color. Regardless of which yucca, true yucca or false yucca, you choose to add into your landscape, they're a great addition to any drought-tolerant, low-maintenance garden, especially in full sun, away from those sidewalks.
Hope you enjoyed this video. It's part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on our OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.